Ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, at first I would like to thank you for all your kindness and friendship. You did such a wonderful job with the exhibition. It is great to see our type designs in the public library together with the other type designers. We thank especially Susie Taylor and her helpers. They did such a great work and it could not be better done. Now I like to show you some slides of my work. Bookbinding, calligraphy and types. Hermann and I, we started with calligraphy in 1934 after the same books from Rudolf Gock and Edward Johnston. He in Nuremberg and I in Weimar as an apprentice of bookbinding. But we met us many years later in Frankfurt. I had there my own bookbinding studio and was teacher for calligraphy at the art school in Frankfurt. There was an exhibition of the work of the teacher and students. One day, Hermann Zapf and the director of the type foundry Die Stempel AG saw this exhibition. They liked my work and I was asked to make a type design that became my first type, the Ultima. Now to the slides. I begin with my early works influenced by Rudolf Koch. That is one of my first books I have written. This is the second, all in black letters. And this is a quotation from Rudolf Koch, also in black letters. Here are the bookbindings with handwritten titles. And this is a leather binding, and on the right side you see the the layout, and after this I have to print with the tools in leather. Here is the book finished. So this is also a book I designed the back and tooled this with in gold. There's also designed letters and with in gold. This also leather binding. I have to look. In 1946 began my first connection with type at the Bauer Foundry, and I was fascinated to see how the punch cutter made punches, and so I asked if I could try myself to do a punch. It worked good so, and so I cut an alphabet in brass, the Hesse Antiqua for gold tooling. Thank you. a little bit. Here I use the types for leather binding. Also printed of vellum, carved vellum, with my types. It's also a quotation from Gerhard Marx, printed in the gold of vellum. This show the preamble of the Charter of the United Nations pressed in thick handmade paper. This is not so good. And here is a cut off out, also in the Hesse Roman, the sign for my bindery. Here are some black letters written with a broad edge pen. This is a book written in Anschel. This is a Matthäus Passion. Passion. Passion, ja. Also a handwritten book. This is the Oath of Hippocrates, written in Roman capitals in 1948. This was on the exhibition when I was a teacher for calligraphy in Frankfurt on the art school. And there was an exhibition, and Hermann and the director of Stempel visited him, and he liked this type and asked me to make a type design for him. And that was the beginning of the Otima. This is a design for in 36 point for the cutting in metal. Here is this. This is the first smoke proof executed by Alfred Rosenberger. He was a very good punch cutter by Stempel. And here you will see the Otima in print. So. This is also a print of the Otima. Here, the use of the Otima for the campaign for Opel Car Company. the firm of General Motors in Germany. Several years they used my type. This is a book binding for the first publication, the first book printed in the Ultima. I was very proud, and so I did some bindings in leather. You will see at the next bindings. This was printed in 36 point the Ultima on this book. Also, thank you.
Yes, into the microphone.
There's another binding. There's the third one. This is the last one. And this is the Ariadne initials I also made for Stempel. This is marked in all caps alphabet. In English, it's emerald. Here you see the smaragd type in use together with the Ultima italic for the document presented to Hermann Hesse when he received the Friedenspreis from the German Book Fair 1955. All these four designs were made for metal types. Alphabet designed to be used for photo composition. I started several years later with Hallmark cards in Kansas City. This was in 1968. I am showing here some of the drawings for the calligraphic Roman and italic. This alphabet was named Shakespeare, for it was first used in a crown edition by Hallmark of Shakespeare's sonnets. The Shakespeare italic were done the first year of photo composition, and all letters had to be fixed within an 18-unit system. For the manufacturing, they needed very precise drawings. That's how I enjoy. I have looked around. Also, this is the design for Nofret, the type. It's not too easy for me.
It is crazy. Just a little louder.
Yes, okay. Yes. This is a bold version of Nofret. This is a italic. This is a, at first it should be the Ultima book, but then we decided that the name should be Nofret, that means the beauty of in Egypt. This was a poster for the first presentation in the United States and Canada, designed by Ed Clary. Nofret is more in the direction of a typeface, but with small caps and different weights for the use in display and jobbing work. Here I would like to mention the first book, which I saw printed in this type. It is designed by Harold Blake in Evanston, Illinois. Alex Osborne's Your Creative Power, published by Motorola University Press. Here is a Carmina, which I designed for Bitstream. This is a italic for Bitstream. And this was a design. In this, I have to make to give them for. What is not so good? This is a design for Christiana, which I did for Berthold, and but you can't buy it anymore because the successor of Berthold, they don't pay any royalties. This is Columbine, one of my last design for URW in Hamburg. This is a black type. This is a design for Alcuin. I did also for URW Hamburg. And that is a handwritten sheet for me. Also, this is a finished also Alcuin. Above it is handwritten and it's a type design. And here I show you some latest design of mine with watercolor. And this is our room in Frankfurt, and this is cut out with letters I did several years ago. This I did for the Goethe House in Frankfurt. This is a letters with aquarelle painted. You have seen this in the exhibition. This was a placard for the exhibition in Frankfurt, in Offenbach. Aquarelle, done with aquarelle color. A black letter. Also done with aquarelle color, watercolor. This is a booklet with I have written 1955. This I cut out letters by design, and I cut it out and put it on this paper. The freelance thing. Designed letters and the small script I did with a bright broad-eyed pen. The design with watercolor. This also. That I did for Steinhauer Press as a New Year's greeting. This also. And this is of one of my latest works, The Beginning of the Genesis, The Creation of the World. I did this when I had finished my type design, and I had it a long time in my mind, so I was glad to have time to execute it. 14 large sheets, four only with text and the other with symbols in this way. Now I am on the end, and I thank you for listening.